tonight, in addition to talking about the Internet of Things and wearables, I want to share with you a problem that I've been having for a really long time. You see, every night I go to bed hoping that I'm going to wake up the next morning and be a morning person. But typically 2-3 snooze buttons later, I've missed my morning run and I'm scrambling out the door. The only times this doesn't happen is when I know someone is counting on me. So maybe someone's waiting to run a lap around Central Park with me. Maybe I have a morning coffee meeting. It's always knowing that someone's counting on me that I skip the extra 10 minutes of snoozing and head out the door. And I think we probably all share this. So how many of you go the whole year without flossing and then the week leading up to your dentist appointment, you're flossing every day? It's having that expectation, knowing someone is expecting a certain outcome that leads you to change. And so why I'm here tonight is to talk about this human component of behavior change, how it's so powerful. A lot of the experts agree with me. So BJ Fogg is a famous one, and his framework for behavior change, that there are motivations, there's ability, meaning how hard is it, and there is a trigger that helps you change. So motivations, as you'll see here, they're all very emotional. We are emotional, we're social beings, and in the presence of another person, this is magnified. Also, when you think about changing, you have to be willing to act, but it has to feel easy to act. And a person can make it feel easier. They can help us not overthink. They can do the work for us, like a coach telling you what to do. And then it's not just one act, but a series of acts that are critical to promote change, to build routines. And a person can cheer you along the way. They can check in. Someone that cares, someone that's holding you responsible, really helps to promote this change. So by now, I hope it's probably clear that people can be really effective, but they can also be very expensive in helping to promote behavior change. When you think about a financial planner, a trainer, it can be very expensive. So that's where technology comes in. It can help to scale this human component of promoting positive change. I want to focus on the fitness industry because there are a lot of things happening there right now, as many of you I'm sure have seen, the Fitbits of the world, the Whitings. They're collecting data, they're helping to promote people to work out more, eat healthier, but they're missing one thing. They're missing that human component. They're not thinking about what we mean by human, these deeper relationships, this idea of synchronous relationships with individuals. And I think a lot of companies are confusing social for human. So it's not the crowd that's holding you accountable, but it's that person. So who's doing this well? A few examples of who's out there today. Weight Watchers, a company that has been famous for their in-person meetings, is now scaling the human component of their weight loss program through technology. Another one is an energy company called O-Power, something you may be familiar with. They're leveraging the power of your relationships with your neighbors to promote change as it relates to helping you be more efficient about consuming energy or using energy. So they'll actually show you who your neighbors are in your neighborhood and then compare how much you are consuming energy compared to them. So thinking about the behavior framework, this motivation of, you know, being socially accepted in terms of your energy consumption is something that they're tapping into. I work for a company called LearnVest right now, and we are using the power of emotional intelligence through technology to help people be better about managing their money. So we give access to a financial planner through through mobile apps. You can co-browse on the web with a financial planner, look at your finances together. They can issue you challenges to help you stay motivated along the way. So another example of how this comes to fruition. So how far could this go? There was a recent article in The Economist that showed people were actually more receptive to opening up to an artificial and emotional intelligent shrink or therapist. So really phenomenal opportunities. And I think what's really exciting about this Internet of Things is that devices are everywhere to empower us and to enable us. And I would encourage any of you working on apps or hardware to think about that human component, because it really is a powerful driver of behavior change. So if you want to chat more, you can find me on Twitter at JQWild, and thanks so much.